All right, so the vice president reigniting a feud this morning with an openly gay Olympian on Team USA. USA Today, the newspaper, reporting that Pence tried to set up a meeting with figure skater Adam Rippon last month. There's nothing wrong with requesting that kind of meeting. Why did he ask for a meeting? Because the skater was critical of the vice president leading the U.S. delegation, saying, quote, "You mean Mike Pence, the same Mike Pence that funded gay conversion therapy? I'm not buying it." Adam appears to be referencing a statement from Pence's 2000 congressional campaign website that reads, "Resources should be directed toward those institutions which provide assistance to those seeking to change their sexual behavior." Now, before Pence was vice president, you may remember he was the governor of Indiana. One of the things that brought him onto the national stage was his open and aggressive support of that state's Religious Freedom Restoration Act, which was a fancy way of saying allow people to use religion to avoid laws mandating equal treatment for the LGBT community. That's what it was. At the time we begged him to come on to defend it, he wouldn't. Joining us now is Adam's mother, Kelly Rippon. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can, Chris. Good morning.
Great. It's good to have you. First things first. Congratulations to the family. We know you must be very nervous. We wish him well, and we are so appreciative of your son representing the country.
Well, thank you.
Because that's, you know, that's what this should be about. However, you now know what's going on. Were you aware if the vice president had asked to meet with your son?
I do not handle his communications. You know, he has an agent and a publicist. But my understanding was that when certain things were published a few weeks ago, I think it was, that his office reached out for a conversation. I don't know about it face-to-face. But I think it was something about that. But I can't be sure about that. So I don't, you know, I can't say that that's true.
And you were aware that your son didn't want to do it?
No, this is the part that I think is misunderstood, Chris. I believe that, you know, you can say it many different ways. I don't think he ever said, "I do that," because that suggests a tone of intolerance and, you know, inflexibility and a closed door. I think what he said was, and what he said to me, the tone that he conveyed to me was, "I have a huge responsibility to give United States figure skating my absolute best performance, and I can't do that having side conversations about different things. I need to put 100% of my energy, like I have all season, on competing and training for the Olympic Games and for the events that he was responsible to give his best performance for." So he conveyed to whomever, I don't know the individuals, that any kind of communication would have to be done after the competition
right.
was over.
Right. I mean, it makes perfect sense.
So
first of all,
instead of saying, "I can't do that," it was reported he refused.
I get it.
I get
your concern with it and wanting to correct it. I mean, he was quoted saying what he was saying. But by the way, you know, he's an American. He's entitled to his opinion about any of these matters. And we would understand his not wanting to be distracted when he has the biggest moment of his life upcoming. What bothered you?
He was never quoted as saying, "I refuse."
No, he was quoted as saying, "The guy who said, that, you know, Mike Pence, the guy who did this and this, no thanks," or whatever. And all that's
in reference to his history.
Understood.
His history to be not supportive of the LGBT community.
Understood. Right. And that's a key distinction for you, because you say what bothered you here was the vice president saying that is fake news. Let's put the tweets up there
at
home.
I don't like that. Yeah.
I know. I get it. And I want you to say why, but I want people to understand what we're talking about first. So Vice President Mike Pence tweeted, "Headed to the Olympics to cheer on Team USA. One reporter," he's talking about Christine Brennan, one of the best sports reporters in the business, "trying to distort 18-year-old non-story to sow seeds of division. We won't let that happen. Fake news." And then he goes on. That bothers you because?
The idea of it bothered me in the one that he addressed Adam with, the one above that, "I want you to know we're all for you," which I think is wonderful. That's terrific. Don't let fake news distract you. And I just think that that when people keep saying that word, fake news, over and over again, it implies that you can do things and you can never be held accountable for them because you just say that it's fake. And I just repetition of that term, I don't think is good.
I agree with you. We deal with it all the time, that fake news for this administration has become a phrase that means we don't like this. And unfortunately, people hear it. And when people read that tweet, to your point, some supporters of the vice president and the president will say, well, I guess they have it wrong about what he said. But everybody can read what was on that website for themselves, what he said about funding services to change sexual behavior. I don't know what else that can mean other than what your son took it as. And in 2015, the vice president was put on the national stage pushing a state law that allowed people to use religion to get around laws for equality for the LGBTQ community. What's your take on that?
Right. I think that that's what he was speaking of, that it was in opposition to equality for all. Not that, say, for instance, when a student is in school and they have a learning plan, it's not to give them an advantage. It's to level the playing field. And protection for equal rights for people isn't to give any group or marginalized community an advantage. It's to try and level the playing field. And I think that, as a mom or as a citizen or just as a human being, we don't want to see anyone be treated, guilted, or shamed into feeling that they're less than who they actually are.
Amen. Tomorrow night, you're going to have one of the proudest moments of your life. You'll be there for the opening ceremony. You'll get to see your son walk in. I know there'll be like a gazillion athletes there, but what will that moment mean to you?
It is a dream come true. It really is. I mean, when I flew over here, there were a few parents from, various sports that were on the same flight that I was on we came out of Atlanta. And, when we spoke to each other, we just met for the first time, but we knew each other because it's very few people, parents of Olympic athletes understand the brutal commitment, the physical drive and commitment that an athlete has to put their bodies through that exceptionally elite level of activity every day and the ups and downs and to have that thick skin. I'm sure he's not following a lot of this. And the conversations that we have are pretty limited.
Good. Hopefully he focuses on the Olympics. Mm-hmm. I'm not getting choked up because of you. I was drinking and choking at the same time.
Yes,
but
it is
very emotional. There, I'm back. It is very emotional. We are